Welcome on Bandra Glasses YouTube channel, and I, Navkant Mishra, with you to discuss some difficult problems regarding chapter 8 of triangles, and hope you have to enjoy this session. My dear student, I have just taken this question, and to simplify, you need to write down 3 angle A is equal to 4 angle B is equal to 6 angle C can be considered it as X. And therefore, 3 angle A is equal to X, and angle A is equal to X upon 3. 4 angle B is equal to X, therefore angle B is equal to X upon 4. And 6 angle C is equal to X, therefore angle C is equal to X upon 6. And we know sum of all angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. This is why angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Or you have to put the value of ABC. The value of A is X upon 3, the value of B is X upon 4, and the value of C is X upon 6 is equal to 180 degree. And after that, you need to simplify. And after simplification, you get X is equal to 240. And by putting X is equal to 240, then you can get angle A is equal to 80 degree, angle B is equal to 60 degree, and angle C is equal to 40 degree. That is the solution of this question. My dear student, in the next question, you can just see that in triangle PQR, angle P minus Q is equal to 42 degree, and angle Q minus R is equal to 21 degree. Then you need to find out the angle PQR. Regarding your solution, the first one has been given, angle P minus angle Q is equal to 42. You have to just rearrange it. Angle P, you have just shift angle Q from LHS to RHS, and then you get 42 plus angle Q, and it is considered as 1. And the second condition has been given, angle Q minus angle R is equal to 21, and again you have to rearrange it, and you get angle R is equal to angle Q minus angle 21. And you know very well that sum of all angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. And after that, you need to put the value of angle P from first on this, and then you get 42 plus angle Q in place of angle P. Q has already been written, and angle R has been taken from second. And what is the value of angle R? Angle Q minus 21, so it has been written. And after simplification, you can get angle Q is equal to 53 degree, and putting the value of 53 in first and second, you can get the value of angle P, R and Q. That is, angle P is equal to 95 degree, Q is equal to 53 degree, and angle R is equal to 32 degree. You can just see that in this question, a right angle triangle has been given, and one acute angle has been given 53 degree, and you have to calculate all angles. Actually, two angles has already given in the triangles. So if you have to calculate the third angle, then all angles you can just write down. The third one I have just considered it as X degree, and this is why by the angle sum property of the triangle, sum of each angle is equal to 180 degree. And by the angle sum property, you know that sum of all angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. This is why X plus 90 degree plus 53 degree is equal to 180 degree. And on simplification, you can get X is equal to 37 degree. So all angles are 37 degree, 90 degree, and 53 degree. My dear student, in this question, you can just see that it has been given that if one angle of a triangle is greater than sum of other two, means sum of other two angles, then you have to prove that the given triangle is obtuse angle triangles. My dear student, for this purposes, a triangle ABC I have just considered, angle A is greater than sum of other two, means other two angles. And if angle A is greater than angle B plus angle C, then you know very well that if you add angle A both sides, then you get angle A plus angle A, and when you add angle A to angle B plus angle C, then you get angle A plus angle B plus angle C. And sum of all angles of your triangle, by angle sum property you know that it is equal to 180 degree, and this is why for angle A plus angle B plus angle C you can write 180 degree. And this is why angle A is equal to 180 upon 2, that is equal to 90 degree. And you know very well that any angle which is greater than 90 degree must be obtuse angle in case of a triangle, because you know very well that the angle of the triangle cannot be equal to 180 degree or greater than 180 degree. And this is why angle A is greater than 90 degree, so the given triangle must be obtuse angle triangle, because by the definition of obtuse angle triangle you know very well that if any angle is greater than 90 degree must be obtuse angle triangle. That is the solution of this question. My dear student, in this question you have to calculate the value of x. For this purposes, at first you need to calculate the value of angle ECD, and actually this angle is in the exterior part of the triangle ABC, and this is why angle ECD is equal to sum of these two angles. So at first you have to calculate this angle, and after that you have to calculate the value of x, because x is the exterior angle of triangle ECD. So two times you have to apply this exterior angle property and you can calculate the value of x. Now you have to just write down integral ABC by exterior angle property. You can write angle ACD is equal to angle ABC plus angle BAC, that is equal to 70 degree. And since ACD is equal to ECD, this is why ECD is also equal to 70 degree. And again you have to apply the exterior angle property in this triangle, and after that you can get x is equal to 120 degree. My dear student, in this question actually you need to calculate the value of x. Regarding the solution of this question, you can just see that you need to extend CD up to E, and E lies on AB. You have just extended, then actually it forms a triangle, and which triangle? ACE. And in this triangle you have to apply exterior angle property, and by applying exterior angle property you can get angle CEB is equal to 85 degree. And when you get this angle 85 degree, then you know very well that x is exterior for the triangle DBE, and this is why again you have to apply exterior angle property. And when you apply exterior angle property in triangle DEB, then you get x is equal to 130 degree. That is the solution of this question. My dear student, in this question it has been given that a figure has been given, and you need to calculate the angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D plus angle E plus angle F, means sum of all its angles is equal to 360 degree. For the solution you need to draw the figure, and after drawing the figure you can just see that this figure contains two triangles. One triangle is actually angle D F B. Actually, one triangle is D F B, and second triangle has been contained. You can just check that it is A C E. And actually, by the angle sum property, you need to calculate the sum of all angles of the triangle separately in both the triangles, and after that you need to add to get this result. Regarding the solution, you have to just write down in triangle BDF, by angle sum property you know that angle B plus angle D plus angle F is equal to 180 degree, and in triangle ACE, by angle sum property, angle A plus angle C plus angle E is equal to 180 degree. And when you add these two, then angle B plus angle D plus F plus angle A plus angle C plus angle E is equal to 180 plus 180 degree. Because when you add any sort of equation, then its LHS is added to LHS and RHS is added to its RHS. And by rearrangement, you can just write down angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D plus angle E plus angle F is equal to 360 degree. Hope you have to enjoy this session. And in next session, I will discuss some more questions regarding these chapters. Thank you very much. Keep watching Vandana Classes YouTube channel.